two, one, and liftoff.
To me, it was smart. There's no rush for this kid. The sky's the limit. Two, it probably is agent-driven, right? Every agent tells their guy, you need to maximize your earning potential. Taking a deal now isn't going to do that for a guy with his skill level. And the third to me is that this is probably a fluid situation. Mm-hmm. That this isn't going to suddenly stop now until 2020 when he's almost on the verge of free agency. They're going to be talking about
this. No, you keep talking. Number three, I think it's smart. Number two, I think it's expected. Number one, the offer was $100 million or whatever it was. I think he's waiting for $200 million. Like, this is where we are with these contracts. The question the Indians are going to have to answer is, do you break the bank for this guy? Because there are only, in the end, two options for the Indians and Francisco Lindor.
Well, I got an email from a guy saying that the Indians aren't being proactive enough, that Bryce Harper is going to break the bank, mm-hmm. and they need to sign this guy before that. Well, guess what? His agent is
probably waiting
for Bryce Harper.
I don't think they're going to go early. I don't think they're not, right? They're going to wait. So do you think in the end, we know the payroll limitations here. We saw them make the exception for Edwin mm-hmm. Encarnacion. Is the exception for this guy? Do you go crazy to keep this guy in Cleveland for his whole career?
This is the one guy you go crazy for.
I think it is too, but I think it may take them buttoning things up a little bit leading up to it to do it. But I do think this is the guy. But in the meantime, enjoy him while he's cheap.